Pero I mean, I would say if more Filipinos would be in this sector, in this field of nursing, I would say siguro less yung burnout.
Would you like to study for the OET but can't seem to find the time? Do you need an excellent OET provider who can flex with your needs? Then choose OET Flex. OET Flex allows you to decide when and how you study the OET on demand. Take Italian qualified nurse L, for example. She needed to pass the OET to work as a nurse in one of the best children's hospitals in the UK. She was working as a healthcare assistant for over 40 hours each week. So she chose OET Flex with native OET teachers online, in person, and timed around her work for 5 weeks. And guess what? Nurse L passed her OET the first time. Learn more at www.oetflex.com.
Hello, Manong George here. Welcome to our channel. And today we have a very...
Yes, my name's Mark Anthony Yap. I'm a registered mental health.
Man knows best.
Similar siya sa like other mental health setting. Apart from yung scope ng Mental Health Act and Mental Capacity Act. So yun yung add-on sa practice. So in terms of mental as a mental health nurse, basically parang primary nurse din yung care sa patient kasi kasama na yung safe discharge. So hanapan namin sila ng accommodation, if fit ba sila doon. Meron din kaming care CPA, meron din kaming tribunal. So they would assess if they are mentally stable na to be discharged in the community. And if they get discharged, hanapan namin sila ng suitable accommodation. So we work hand in hand with the community team. So very, very wide yung scope ng psychiatry dito. Kasi under siya sa Mental Health Act. So hindi siya parehas nung, I would say, like general hospital na after mong gumaling, discharge ka na agad sa bahay mo. Sa psychiatry, hanapan pa siya ng safe accommodation.
Man knows best.
Inpatient kami. So, yung hospital namin, acute and rehabilitation. So, yung unit ko, rehabilitation.
A mental
hospital namin, iba't ibang services siya. So, may PQ, mayroong acute, may rehab, may eating disorder. So lahat nung nasa scope ng psychiatry na inpatient. Yun yung services namin.
Man knows best.
Pwede ata yun kasi ang pagkakaalam ko yung ibang trust na based dun sa mga nakilala ko na ibang, kasi dumadami na yung mga Filipino. So, yung iba, yung trust nila yung nag-sponsor to study as a mental health.
Man knows best.
Kasi malawak yung scope ng mental health. Eh. Meron kang, marami kang options. Pwede kang sa community, pwede kang sa outpatient, depo clinic. So it varies eh. It varies talaga. Pwede kang inpatient, pwede kang mag agency, pwede ka sa prison. So it's dito sa UK ko lang na nakita yung scope ng mental health nurse. It's very wide and vast na marami kang options after.
Man knows best.
And to answer your question, retirement age, I think it's the same as the others, other fields of nursing. Pero yung pros, yung mostly pros because in a good day, seasonal yung napapansin ko eh. So if you're in an acute ward na very unwell yung patient or in PQ ward, pag unsettled sila, talagang may season na unsettled. Pero once na-treat na sila through medication and through psychology and OT, nagsistabilize sila. And once na yung buong ward or buong unit is nag-respond sa treatment, mostly, I would say na medyo okay yung flow compared. Hindi siya ganun ka-intensive compared sa medical ward or ICU or A&E, I would say. Especially sa rehab na stable, somewhat stable na yung karamihan ng mga ready for discharge na, I mean. Yung pathway nila is more on stability. Pero I would say it's less hectic. Those are, ayun ang pros. Pwede kang mag-long day ng 5 araw na sunod, 6 na sunod. If you want to. Hindi ka ganun ka bugbog. And kung nasa rehab ka, mas stable yung patient, mas I would say lesser yung workload ng staff. Hindi magulo, less response mo sa challenging behavior sa patients na very unwell. So once they stabilize sila yung buong ward mostly, it's just like a normal day. You know, medications, kakain sila, mag-engage sila sa therapy, lalabas, pabalik. Just like a normal person pag maganda yung response nila sa medication.
Man knows best.
Yes. Yung symptoms sa mental health, yun talaga nakita mo. I mean, may yung mostly schizophrenia, mostly by nature, na-exacerbate ng illicit drug use, ganon. I would say 90% ng mga patients namin is ang nature ng kanilang mental, ng kanilang ng illness is due to drug use. Pag distress sila, meron kami mga PRN medications, meron mga rapid tranquilization, ganon.
So, totoo yun sa movies, yung parang nagwawala sila, takihin mo sila ng injection.
somewhat totoo. Actually, may mga training on how to, dami nilang terms dati. Ngayon, ang tawag na nila, safety intervention on how to manage yung mga agitated na mga pasyente or mga challenging patients. Ang dami ng trainings niya. Ang dami na talaga trainings. At saka, mas, I would say, yung medications dito sa UK compared sa Philippines, mas potent siya, I would say. Mas maraming options yung mga patient compared sa Philippines and Middle East na ilan lang antipsychotics yung available.
Man knows best.
Burnout. Actually, kahit na lalo sa acute na almost every day yung ward rounds. Kasi sa amin sa rehab every Wednesday lang. So once a week lang siya. So almost the entire day, nakaupo ka lang, magbibigay ka lang ng feedback and the rest of the MDT. And then, sobrang bagal kasi talaga ng discharge dito sa rehab. Lalo maghanap na ng mga na accommodation nila, ng mga bahay nila, o saan sila titira after discharge. Doon tumatagal eh. So longer yung stay nila sa amin.
Always remember, Manong knows.
Manong knows best, put your worries to rest when staying in the United Kingdom. Manong knows best.